Right now. All right, what's up everybody? Welcome back to a brand new YouTube video. Doing a little bit different for this video today because it's nothing fitness related. With prep starting up, I did want to do something a little bit different. I did want to do a little food challenge because I didn't want to go through prep thinking that I should have had this or I should have had that. Well, I still could. So that's what we're gonna do today. We're gonna do a food challenge. So initially what I was gonna do is that I was gonna pick a spot in the city and then kind of have all my meals at that one spot. But I kind of thought about it and I felt it would have been more of a hassle to just keep going back and forth to the exact same spot and not really changing location. So I thought about it a little more and I am actually craving burgers. So what I'm gonna do for today is gonna do like a signature burger challenge. So what this entails is that I'm gonna just hit up different spots around my area and then kind of just eat their signature burger. So I'm gonna aim to do 5 today. We'll see how my stomach feels as we kind of roll on, but that's what we're gonna do today. But yeah, we'll see how it goes and then off to the first stop.
Can I just get the regular just team burger? Just one team burger?
Yeah. What, inside or takeout?
Ah, takeout. Yeah. Awesome.
So first stop I saw, we hit up A&W. So what I've got here is a team burger. And I feel like it's one of those burgers where if you go to A&W, you have no idea what to get. Most people will just opt for the team burger. So here it is right here. Kind of pretty standard. You got the lettuce up top, you got the tomato, the patty and cheese in the middle. And this one's actually a little bit saucier than I remember. It's been a while since I had a team burger, so what a better way to reintroduce this. But yeah, let's take the first bite. Honestly, I don't know what it is about A&W burgers, but compared to like other fast food restaurants, they always taste like super fresh, like the meat is actually real, if that makes sense. But yeah, a lot of flavor in this one. Again, it's a staple burger that I feel like everybody will opt to go with at any time they're at A&W. Forgot to mention there's some pickles and onions in here too, which you could really taste. But even the bun itself, it's like crispy. It's not like those soft, soggy buns that you get at other places. Yeah, I don't know, I think like with A&W, it's like you can't go wrong with any of their burgers. All right, burger number one down, on to the next one. Hey, how's it going? Can I just get one Big Mac sandwich? And that's all. Sweet, awesome, thanks. All right, so stop number two, as you heard, we got the classic Big Mac from McDonald's over here. I feel like it's been almost over a year since I had my last Big Mac. I remember as a kid, like my mom used to like buy me this all the time because she used to have all these coupons. I think it was like a 2 for $5 type of deal. Can't remember if you still get them now or if the prices have risen up since then, but get a closer look at this. So we got here, classic sesame bun, the two patties. What else we got in here? Hold on. So yeah, we got a few onions, some shredded lettuce. Yeah, and then the classic Thousand Island Big Mac sauce over there. But yeah, typically I'm not a super huge fan of the Big Mac. I feel like over the years, there's been better burgers that other companies have just made and other fast food restaurants that I feel like taste better. Or maybe it's the fact I had it so many times as a kid that I kind of got sick of it. But we're gonna try this again. Let's see if my opinion stays the same. Yeah, honestly, it tastes exactly how I remembered. It's that sauce. It's the Mac sauce that makes it distinct that you know it's from McDonald's. And I don't know if it's just me, but I don't know if the patties have gone thinner, but that compared to like the A&W burger, this thing is just thin. You don't really get much meat out of it. Right, so that was stop number two. Not a bad burger. There are better ones out there for sure. A&W still tops it compared to the original Big Mac. But we finally tried that out over what it seems like over a year since I had my last Big Mac. But yeah, on to stop number three. All right, so for stop number three, there was no way I wasn't gonna do this for the signature burger challenge, but you all know me, when it comes to the sandwich, we got the signature Popeye's chicken sandwich, and just like I said in my last video, the spicy one, never the original. And just as usual, look how big this chicken is. Look at that. Then you got the, and then you got the pickle inside as well. Like I said before, there is no better chicken sandwich than Popeye's. Try to prove me wrong, comment down below if you have another suggestion that kind of tops it. It's just that combination of crunch and just how juicy the chicken is. This right here checks all the boxes off. Not gonna lie, I am starting to get full. Definitely slowing down a bit here, but we're gonna keep on pushing. All right, so that was the Popeye's chicken sandwich. Solid sandwich as always. Again, get the spicy, not the original. But yeah, that was stop number three. Now we're going on to number four. Take you there, gotta take you there. Hey, how's it going? Can I just get one Whopper sandwich?
Awesome.
All right, thank you. All right, so for the fourth stop, I was like, since I did McDonald's, I'm gonna do the rival counterpart. At least I think they're still their rival counterpart. But as you saw in the previous clip, we are here at Burger King, and I pretty much grabbed their signature Whopper. Kind of effed up on the purchase though, because apparently it was 2 for $9. But I went for the one sandwich only, which was like $6. So for an extra $3, I could've got a second sandwich. Anyways, we just stuck with one. And just like the Big Mac sandwich, I haven't had this in like over a year. This thing's like messy. You know what? I'm just gonna keep it in the wrapper because I feel like this is gonna just fall apart. All right, so here's a look at it all. So you got a bunch of tomatoes, pickles, the one patty, and then a bunch of mayo and lettuce up top. A lot more messier than the other burgers that I've tried so far. And let's take the first bite with this one. And then this one's also a lot bigger than the other burgers. Hence the name Whopper, right? How's my face looking right now? I feel like since the beginning of the video, it's like expanded with all these burgers. Also too, I don't know if you noticed, it's kind of a weird thing that I do with when I eat in large quantities. I tend to not drink any liquids or any water as I eat. I feel like it's something that I adopted early on, and it was like I try to make it like a strategy type thing where in my head it's like if I drink water it's just gonna make me more full, so therefore I can't eat as much. Probably super unhealthy for you, but that's kind of the mindset I had when it came to like eating at buffets and just eating a large amount of foods in one go. But yeah, I think for my next burger, I'm gonna get a drink because I'm getting really thirsty now. Also, I feel like this is the burger that's gonna get me full too. Just one more bite. All right, so that was number four. That one was a tough one. It's starting to hit me now. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna snag up the fifth and final burger, but I'll eat it a little bit later on in the day. But yeah, I don't wanna be puking, so I think that's what we're gonna do. But yeah, let's get burger number five.
All right, so it's much later in the day and a few hours has passed already, but not gonna lie, still feel pretty full even after that that Burger King Whopper. But I did say we're gonna do five today. So to end this challenge off, I'm gonna show you what I got for my last burger. But for the last one, I went to Wendy's and we grabbed their also famous Baconator right here. So that's the Baconator sandwich. So you got two patties, a bunch of bacon up top, cheese, and basically no veggies. So kind of fits my bill. So I had to reheat this as well. So it might not taste as great as if I were to get it fresh, but the bun is still pretty hot. So even the bottom one. So I'm gonna actually let this cool down and then we're gonna get to the full experience. Okay, so I give it a couple of minutes, so we're just gonna dig into this right away. That was pretty good. No, I don't go to Wendy's very often.
But when I do, I always either get like a Baconator or something with a lot of patties in it. I feel like it's one of those places where you just gotta go all out. But definitely, I feel like this is their signature sandwich. Well, I guess just to add, in between the hours that I took a break, did get some water in, so well hydrated for this. But yeah, like I said before, still feeling pretty full, but definitely manageable. All right, one last little bite. All right, so that was 5 signature burgers down in one day. Honestly, if I spread the burgers apart, this challenge would have been a lot easier. But since the first 4 were like very close together, it was kind of tough to, especially after the Whopper, after downing that it started to get really, really tough on the stomach. But we did it, we accomplished it. I guess if I were to rank the burgers, I would for sure put still Popeyes number 1. That's kind of like my bias. Number 2, I'll give it to the teen burger for A&W. There's something about it that just overall like is really, really good, and just the freshness of it adds another factor to it. Baconator number 3. And then for the last 2, I feel like I put the Big Mac number 4 and then the Whopper number 5. And I kind of got curious as I was eating that burger. So I'm gonna check the total macros of what I had today for all 5 burgers. All right, so I found each item on MyFitnessPal. So here are the macros as shows. Hopefully it's not inverted, but there it is. I'll read them out as well. So for protein, it's 165, carbohydrates 223. And then for the fat content, it's 209, a whopping 209 grams of fat. And for the total calories altogether, it's 3,449. Yeah, that's pretty much it. We're just gonna wrap it up there. Hope you guys enjoyed this challenge. It was something I wanted to do before we start prepping 4 weeks. I think I'm pretty sure it's 4 weeks. Basically, the end of February is where we kind of dialed in and kind of shoot for the first show. But yeah, once again, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Please like the video, subscribe to the channel, comment down below. I'm thinking about doing another food challenge, one more before we start prep again. So if you have any ideas, let me know. But other than that, catch you on the next video.